In this presentation, we will be illustrating how to take apart and reassemble a quad split fan. This style of fan comes fully assembled from the factory. The tools that you may need are a rubber mallet, Allen wrenches, a torque wrench with a proper size socket for your hub, the wrenches to fit your cone bolts, split bolts, and base bolts. Take a marker and go around the cone flange in a few spots for alignment during reassembly. Remove the bolts from the inlet cone and then remove the cone from the fan. Now the cone may be held in place by foam tape. You may need to pry the cone loose to remove it. The shaft and wheel bushing have black protectant on it that will need to be removed. You can use brake cleaner or carb cleaner to remove the protectant. Make sure you wear proper safety gear. Once the protectant is removed, take a scribe or marker and mark the wheel hub location of the key. Also mark the location of the bushing on the shaft or take a note of the measurement at the end of the shaft to the bushing. Loosen the set screw in the bushing. Remove the bushing according to the instructions found in the fan pack. Once the bushing is removed, remove the wheel with the forklift. It helps to put a block of wood across the forks to help balance the wheel. Smaller wheels can be lifted out by hand. To gain access to the bolts from the drive side of the fan housing, remove any weather hood panels if it has them. Now, if there's a seal, you may need to unbolt it and slide it towards the bearing before you can proceed. Now you can remove the bolts from the pedestal to the housing and the isolation base. Separate the housing from the pedestal. Remove bolts from the split sections beginning at the top and place the sections on the skids. Be careful not to damage the parts. Now for reassembling the unit, place the pedestal on a flat surface or isolation base. When bolting the housing split sections back together, be sure that the gasketing is intact. Put all the bolts in before tightening them. Once the housing split bolts are tight, move the housing to the pedestal and bolt the two pieces together. If there's a seal, bolt it back into place. Place the wheel on the shaft and slide the bushing on the shaft to the scribe mark, or the measurement you had noted before removing it. Tighten the set screws in the bushing. Pull the wheel hub onto the bushing. Make sure the key is lined up with the mark on the wheel hub. Snug the bushing bolts to the wheel hub. Ensure the sealing tape is intact and undamaged. Then install the cone, leaving the bolts loose enough to align the cone with the marks on the housing or evenly spaced within the wheel. Rotate the wheel to make sure it does not rub on the inlet cone. Tighten the inlet cone bolts. If necessary, you may need to adjust the wheel positioning by loosening the wheel hub bolts and set screw. Take a straight edge and hold it tight against the wheel cone, just so it touches the inlet cone, as shown in the diagram. Once the inlet cone and wheel overlap are correct, use the torque wrench to tighten the set screws and wheel bushing bolts according to the manufacturer's recommendation. Rotate the wheel again to double check the clearances. After completion, review the IOM. It is recommended to have the fan checked for any vibration after startup.